this bad feeling. And of course, you don't say that before the game, but he admits it after the game. And they just did not, they weren't on. They didn't shoot well that night. You're going to have that sometimes. So, you know, but like you said, both those losses, Randy, to very good basketball teams, they have not lost a game where you looked at it and said, whoa, how did they lose that? They've lost to two tremendous teams. Of course, GW ranked number one in the state right now. So,
well, let's look at the seniors on this Parkersburg High School team. Looking numerically, the first senior on the team is Connor Loudon, doing a great job for the Big Red football team earlier this year and is going to be attending Princeton. He's a 6'4 senior, 210, and you talk about senior leadership, it couldn't start at a better place.
Absolutely not. It's a shame he couldn't kick the basketball. It'd probably go in all the time, the way his foot works. Tremendous field goal kicker. Not as good of a basketball player, but yet he's got that leadership, like you said, that certainly makes him a valuable part of this team.
Numerically, next is Kyle Bowles. He's a 6'1 senior and 170, and you and I both know Kyle real well, and he has really improved over the years, and for Coach Brewer, you couldn't ask for a better person to come off on the bench and be the hustler that you want him to be and to be the spark plug you need him to be.
Yeah, absolutely, and I've known him for a long, long time, and he's just a real nice guy. I mean, he's not a person that's going to get in trouble. Just off the court, very nice person, and someone you like to see to succeed. And he's had to work at it. You know, when he first came to PHS, you know, he didn't get any playing time. He wasn't a great player, but he's one of these people where he's put in the hard work and become a much better player.
Right. Looks like we're getting ready to come up to time to sing the national anthem, but real quickly, let's just kind of go through the rest of the seniors for Parkersburg High School. Number 23, a 6'4", 200-pound senior, Sean Michael. Also at 6'6", 250 pounds, is senior Jared Decker. And at 6'6", you'd say, well, this kid has to be the tallest kid on the court, but he is the next to the tallest kid on the court. So far as that's concerned, the tallest person on the court is center number 40, Anthony Smith, who I always say is a men among boys on the court here, because you look at Anthony and he looks like he's either a pro player or a college basketball player. Let's go down courtside now to pick up the national anthem.
And bright stars for the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, was so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rebel of our spokesmen gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Good job by Parkersburg High School singers as they bring you the national anthem. And I was talking about that last night at Parkersburg South as well. The talent in terms of singers is just as deep as the talent on the athletic field. Both schools have always done phenomenal jobs as bringing the national anthem. And Sean being one who's actually done it before, it's quite an honor.
Yeah, it is. And, you know, both the choirs at Parkersburg High School, Parkersburg South, high above the rest of the state, really, just speaking from personal experience, just such a good program at both schools, and it is. It's fun to sing the national anthem at these games. It gets you excited.
Well, we get set now to bring you the introductions. Getting ready to introduce the starters for PHS for the final time at home here this year. Jay Smith being introduced now. He's a 5'7", 140 senior. Number 13, Connor Loudon, 6'4", 210. Kyle Bowles, 6'1", 170 senior, being introduced. And 6'4", 200-pound senior, Sean Michael, wearing number 23. And at 6'6", 250, a senior, Jared Decker. And 6 foot, 175, senior Chris Krakula. And here comes Anthony Smith. He's 6'8", 275. And like I say, he's a man among boys, Sean.
It's like a tractor trailer rolling up to the field house.
So we're going to get set to introduce the starters now for both teams. Good crowd on hand tonight, Sean.
Yeah, it really is. A very, very nice crowd for senior night here at Parkersburg High School.
Well, there's number 10, Michael Moore, and he doesn't look like the Michael Moore I'm thinking of. 6'1", 151 pounds, wearing number 10.
Probably doesn't have the money that Michael
Moore
is
thinking
of.
That's exactly right. Number 11 is Matt Godfrey, a 6 foot, 175 senior. Number 14 is Jeremy Adams, a 5'9", 140 junior. And number 22 is Jordan Morrison. He's 6'3", 165, and a sophomore.
And Randy, their record is 9-10, but we were discussing this before the game. Really, that's probably not an indication of their talent, because
right.
each year they're a very competitive basketball team. They play a hard schedule.
Well, one starter I missed there for Robert C. Byrd, number 44, Jonathan Griffin, 6'2", 200 pounds. Now we get set to introduce the Big Reds. Number 13, Connor Loudon. And number 23, Sean Michael. Number 24, Jeremy Dunaway. Wearing 33, Chris Krakula. And number 40, Anthony Smith. Well, we get set to bring you the basketball game tonight here from the Edgar Rhodes Memorial Fieldhouse. And Robert C. Byrd, as you mentioned, Sean, comes in at 9-10. Parkersburg High, 19 wins to their credit, and opposed to 2 losses. For the Big Reds tonight, they'll be starting 4 seniors and 1 junior. For Robert C. Byrd, they'll be starting 3 seniors, 1 junior, and 1 sophomore.
Well, for the Big Reds, so much senior leadership on the court for Parkersburg High School. These are kids that have been there, they've done that, and just a very experienced team. And as you mentioned, for Robert C. Byrd, not so much. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays out with so many seniors on the court for Parkersburg High School.
Both teams exchanging greetings. Anthony Smith for the Big Reds at center court. He'll match up with, looks like, 6 foot Matt Godfrey.
Wonder who'll win the jump ball.
We'll see. It's according to how high the ref throws it.
I'll bet you some money on that.
Anthony Smith controls it for the Big Reds, gets it to Connor Loudon, then back to Dunaway. He sets up the play, passes it to his right to Chris Krakula, looks down the center to Sean Michael, but it'll go out, and the Big Reds will retain possession as it was off a Robert C. Byrd flying eagle. Connor Loudon gets set to inbound it, looks for someone to get it to, gets it to Anthony Smith, spoons it back to Loudon. Dunaway looks to his right to Strakula for 3, drills it.
And the Big Reds, Randy, have some shooters, and can't leave them open for a split second.
And if you do, that's exactly what's going to happen. Jeremy Adams looks to his left to Jonathan Griffin for 3, off the iron, won't go.
Smallest guy on the court, Dunaway there, Randy.
Dunaway
with the rebound.
With a rebound, Strakula for 3, a little bit hard. Rebounded, brought down by Michael Moore for the Eagles. Looks cross court to Morrison. Morrison tries to drive the baseline. He's going to pass it at the last minute. Griffin, top of the key, then to Jeremy Adams, to Jonathan Morrison. Shot taken by Michael Moore. Goes left of the rim. Dunaway comes down court. Goes to his left, looking for some help. He's going to kick it underneath to Connor Loudon. He tries to take the shot. He'll draw the foul.
That was a nice feed by Dunaway as he penetrated there in the lane and kicked it over to Loudon.
Foul's going to go against Matt Godfrey, his first, team first. Just underway here. Big Reds lead 3-0, and Connor Loudon will have the opportunity to make it 5-0 as he will be shooting two, as he was in the act of shooting during that foul. First one's up.
And if you've just, ever... Oh, sorry, go ahead,
just
Brandon.
Kind of a matter of fact.
Well, if you've ever watched the Big Reds play, they do not have too many bad free throw shooters.
They
do not miss from the free throw line, and I'm glad I didn't jinx him. I was a little nervous after I said that.
I tell you, Connor Loudon during the last South game was 13 of 13 from the free throw line. Big Red steal that one, and it's restolen. Dunaway kicks it back to Loudon, up a little hard. Retried there by Shawn Michael. Finally put in, I believe, by Anthony Smith. Mike Moore gets it over to Jeremy Adams. They'll swing it around to Godfrey, who's in heavy traffic. Looks over to Jonathan Griffin to his right. Adams back to Godfrey. Shot taken a little bit hard off the rim. Jordan Morrison takes that one. Big Red's coming down the court. Great job there, right up the middle by Shawn Michael. And Robert C. Byrd said, that's enough for right now, guys. Let's talk about this for a minute. Shawn, Big Red's coming on strong here in the first quarter.
Well, right now for Robert C. Byrd, they just need to find somebody that could shoot the ball. They've gone over 2 minutes here in this first quarter and yet to score, and just a nice job of passing so far for the Big Reds. Just precise passing at the offensive end of the court, and suddenly you look up at the scoreboard, Randy, and it's 9-0 before you know it.
Well, also, the Big Reds have done a good job defensively, kind of blocking out that basket as Robert C. Byrd's tried to get in there, but they tried the baseline, they tried the center. It just wasn't happening, and so they tried to take some outside shots, and whenever you're forced with the outside shots, depending on what kind of night you're having, you're either on or off, and right now Robert C. Byrd is in the latter of the two positions.
Well, you don't want
both shots that they've taken from three-point territory have been a little bit hard.
And the rebound, and if I have this correct, is 6-0 in favor of the Big Reds. Just no rebounds for Robert C. Byrd yet.
Godfrey looks to Morrison, cross court to Adams, goes to Godfrey, who tries to drive it. He tries to pass it away at the last minute to Griffin, stolen away by the Big Reds.
Oh, wow.
And there's Shawn Michael. Makes it 11-0. Morrison outside to Godfrey, tries to drive the baseline. Shot too hard. Rebound brought down by Connor Loudon, and he's going to be tied up by Matt Godfrey. Big Reds got the initial tip, so this jump ball will be out to Robert C. Byrd.
Well, right now for Robert C. Byrd, a recipe for disaster. They're not shooting and they're not rebounding, so
right.
If you don't do either one of those, you're in trouble.
Eugene Weekly in for the Flying Eagles. Coach thinking maybe bringing some new blood in might help a little bit. Weekly looks to his left to Morrison. Morrison drives up and couldn't quite find the bottom of the net. Adams passes over, and that'll be a three-point opportunity made by Jordan Morrison. But Shawn Michael turns it the other way and puts two more on the board just as easily.
Robert C. Byrd is having a tough time getting back on defense right now, Randy, and that's killing him.
Jeremy Adams looks to his left to Weekly. That'll go out, they say, off the Big Reds. So Weekly will inbound it. You got Drew Skasic, Stephen Collins, and Michael Moore returning for the Flying Eagles. Coach substituting
quite frequently early on.
Pretty wholesale right now. 3:04 left on the clock, left in the first quarter of play. Big Reds a 10-point margin, 13-3. Pass into Derek Patsy. There again, ball control is a problem. And that's going to go out to Robert C. Byrd. They say it was off of Connor Loudon.
And Clyde Brewer just threw his hands up in the air and said, there's a player of mine on the floor. I'm not sure if that was a foul or not.
20 years ago, that would have been a stomp that everybody would have heard.
You know, it's just the arms in the air now. They get the ball nevertheless.
Chris Dracula gets it to Jerome Donaway, who brings it across the timeline for the Big Reds. Looks to Dracula, back to Donaway, out to Sean Michael, then to Dracula, over to Loudon. Donaway kicks it back to Dracula. No, check that. It's Sean Michael with the basket. And that's six now, for eight for Dracula, Sean Michael.
Maybe I should come announce every game. It seems to have a good game every time I'm here.
That'll be out to the Big Reds, as it was off of Robert C. Byrd.
And Robert C. Byrd right now just not into the game. There's no flow to their offense. The Big Reds are just picking apart the Eagles' defense right now, the Flying Eagles' defense.
Eagles are just kind of in a damage control situation, and it's not working.
No.
Strakula for three, a little bit short. Picked up by Weekly. Gets the pass up to Michael Moore, looking for someone to get it to at the last minute. Passes it off to Drew Skasic, then to Griffin. Coming up with a rebound is Dracula for the Big Reds. Goes to Dunaway for three, and is off the back of the rim. Rebounded by Derek Patsy. He's going to try to drive the baseline up. Anthony Smith says, I don't think so.
Boy.
Kyle Bowles, Jared Decker, and Seth Bostaff will now come in for the Big Reds.
It's like you think you're in the clear, you make a nice move, and there's Anthony Smith.
Weekly, all the way out to Michael Moore. Back to Weekly. Derek Patsy, he'll take a three, and it'll be no good. Rebounded by Bostaff. Pass up front to Loudon. Loudon back to Bostaff. Spoons it up to Sean Michael, and he's got 10.
And it's stolen at the other end by Kyle Bowles. Boy, if you're Robert C. Byrd, you want to get out of this first quarter.
Shot taken there by Sean Michael.
He missed.
And they say that Robert C. Byrd batted the ball out of bounds, so the Big Reds will inbound it. Bostaff to Decker. Stolen in midair by the Eagles. Drew Skasic takes the shot. It's deflected out by Kyle Bowles, but that's after the foul.
He did a nice job of turning his body, Randy, and drawing a foul. Because if you look out there, the Big Reds certainly have the size advantage. And
right.
Anything to get the ball underneath every once in a while for some points.
Foul's going to go against Connor Loudon, his first, team first, and at the free throw line, Drew Skasic hits the first of two with an opportunity to put another one on the board. He does so, and it's a 17-5 game. Bostaff inbounds at the Bowles, back to Bostaff as we come across the timeline. Kicks it out to Kyle Bowles. Goes over to Connor Loudon. Decker underneath. Takes the shot, he'll be fouled, and that's going to go against Stephen Collins, which will be his first.
And I cannot emphasize enough the pretty ball movement so far for the Big Reds.
Just, right.
And hardly even picking up a dribble. They're just swinging the ball from one side to the other, and there's a missed free throw for the Big Reds.
First one is no good for Jared Decker. Second one's up, and it's in. 18-5, our score here. Skasic going to try to baseline one more time. He gets the pass back to Stephen Collins. Retaken there by Michael Moore. He gets it to Morrison, takes the shot. That's for two. But it'll bring the Flying Eagles back to within 11 now. 2 minutes left here in the opening period. We're still in the first quarter, guys.
Yeah, we are. And seems like we've been here a lot longer than that, doesn't it?
And Jared Decker.
Kyle Bowles with the steal, and he got fouled.
Great job there.
That's twice he's done that.
Yes, it is. And this time he'll have the opportunity to put points on the board on account of it. Stephen Collins will be tagged with the foul. That's his second, team foul number three. Kyle Bowles at the free throw line, shooting two.
You can't afford to throw the inbounds pass away when you've got three players to the Big Reds, one player, and that's exactly what's happened twice now for Robert C. Byrd.
A lot of arc on it. Didn't hit anything but the bottom of the net.
Almost hit the ceiling, I think.
Chris Davison will come into the game for the Eagles. Kyle Bowles with the second free throw is up and good. Davison inbounds it to Drew Skasic as they come across the timeline for the Flying Eagles. Turns to his left, and the foul is going to be called very quickly there on Kyle Bowles. That is his first, team foul number two. This will be a possession foul. So the Eagles will have it out.
Boy, he went over and back with it as his left foot traveled back over. So just some goofy turnovers, Randy, here in the opening quarter for Robert C. Byrd.
If you're the coach of the Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles right now, Bill Bennett, you're thinking to yourself, you're hearing the Outer Limits music about now. Bowles over to Loudon, back to Bowles, to Sean Michael, or to Sean Michael. Robert C. Byrd trying to get some more points on the board. Just pounded by Kyle Bowles as Jordan Morrison tried to get that one in. Boy, when the Big Reds mess up, they're still able to control it, aren't they?
I was going to say, when it goes bad, it goes bad for you.
Kyle Bowles.
Maybe he meant to bounce it off his foot, but I don't know.
Loudon pass to Bostaff, over to Decker. Spoons it in. My gosh, what a play. Sean Michael took the shot. It wouldn't go in, but Connor Loudon comes up with a rebound and the points. My goodness. Eugene Weekly.
They could wear blindfolds, I think, Randy, and they would still end up scoring in this first quarter. They've almost scored 30 points in the first quarter of play.
Michael Moore. Drew Weekly. Then Derek Patsy tries to take it in. Deflected out by Sean Michael.
They just cannot get anything going on the inside. And this is good to see as Chase Smith, not a person that gets very much playing time at all. As a senior, he's going to get some playing time.
Yeah, you can see the student body kind of standing up, cheering him on. As you hear it there, let's go, Chase.
And he's just kind of smiling about it.
Eagles get the pass in to Drew Skasic. He gets it to Derek Patsy, over to Eugene Weekly. Back to Skasic. Shot taken from the right wing by Derek Patsy. He's good. Inside 10 seconds now left to go here in the first quarter of play. Bostaff back to Smith. And it won't go.
You were just hoping that would go in for him, but it did not.
Place would have erupted if that would have went in.
I think so.
7/10 of a second, all's left here in the first quarter.
Boy, Kyle Bowles is hustling.
Yes, he is. So after one quarter of play here at the Memorial Fieldhouse, it is the Big Reds 26, the Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles 9. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Hi, I'm Katie Molinari, and for the past 2 years, I've been in Morgantown playing soccer for WVU. But before I was a Mountaineer, I suited up and played for the Patriots, right here. A lot has been accomplished at the Erickson Off-Course facility, and the construction of the grandstand will be the final step towards the completion of this awesome goal. Hundreds of you deserve our thanks and gratitude for turning this dream into a reality.
Thank you, Wood County.
Erickson All-Sports Facility, sponsored by Cosenza and Merriman, attorneys at law, when only the best will do.
Go South!
The Postal Annex in South Parkersburg is your shipping and copying center. The guys at the Postal Annex make it easy to ship your packages. They carry packing supplies, boxes, and they can even package up what you are sending for you. You can be sure your package will make it safely. The Postal Annex ships FedEx.
Back into second quarter action at the Memorial Fieldhouse. Michael to Donaway. Looks to his left to Loudon. Looking for some help, gets it to Anthony Smith, and that will go off of Anthony Smith. Robert C. Byrd will inbound it. After the first quarter, Sean, interesting, 12 points for Sean Michael, 3 points for Jared Decker, as well as Chris Tekula, 4 points for Connor Loudon, 2 points for Kyle Bowles, and also for Anthony Smith.
Well, right now, Sean Michael is outscoring the entire Robert C. Byrd team.
Eugene Weekly with that shot. Morrison with 5, 2 points for Drew Skasic, and Derek Patsy with 2 points is the scoring right now. Well, at the end of first quarter scoring for Robert C. Byrd. Connor Loudon for 3, little short. Anthony Smith rebound, turnaround, hook shot, won't go. And we're going to have a foul called on Anthony Smith.
That was a frustration foul. He turned around. I'm not sure if he lost control of the ball or just didn't know where he was at on the court, but he was not even close on his hook shot, and fouled out of the process.
Team fouls on both sides of the ball, 3 right now. So neither team in any foul trouble, or neither team looking for a 1-1. Godfrey gets it to Derek Patsy. Looks for someone to get it to. Stolen away by Chris Tricula. In heavy traffic, he'll be fouled. That's going to go against Eugene Weekly, and that is his first team foul, number 4. And that could have gone 1 of 2, as actually Strakula was caught in the middle of an Eagle sandwich. Donaway to Loudon, over to Strakula. Loudon trying to get it underneath, but just no room there to get it. But why do you need that whenever you've got somebody like Chris Tricula taking those shots like that? Sean Michael tries to do a little bit of razzle-dazzle to Connor Loudon. Connor says, "You passing it to me?" Didn't see it coming.
I thought he was a globetrotter for a second because he went behind the back, and I don't think Coach Brewer really liked that too well.
Jeremy Adams looking for someone to get it to. Gets it to Derek Patsy. And they are just not able to get that penetration. Connor Loudon coming up with a steal. Up too hard, but he's going to be fouled.
Ooh, that was a late call. And obviously, Byrd player they called on just kind of looked at him.
Matt Godfrey and Robert C. Byrd coach had a little bit of questioning for the official. The official explained it to him, and that pretty well nailed it shut. He understood. Loudon will be shooting 2. First one's up, and it's in. And that's his first points of the second quarter. Big Reds with a 27-11 lead here with 6 minutes, 4 seconds left to go in the half. Robert C. Byrd inbounds it to Matt Godfrey. Across the timeline, a little razzle-dazzle, and that didn't work either.
Just stick with the basics is the message we're getting here.
Weekly. Pass to Godfrey. He gets it to Derek Patsy, and he'll be fouled by Anthony Smith. That'll be his second.
Two quick ones on Smith. It almost looked clean, but we're not down there by the action, so referee had a much better angle of it.
That's his second, and at the free throw line will be Derek Patsy shooting 2. Getting set to come in for the Big Reds is Seth Bostaff. First one's up and in. And for the Eagles, Jordan Morrison and Jonathan Griffin will report in. Derek Patsy, after the first one goes in, will have the opportunity to make a second one. Off the back of the iron, rebounded by the Big Reds and retaken by Matt Godfrey. Shot taken is, didn't look like it had a chance by Jonathan Griffin,
wasn't
but it went
pretty,
in.
But it went in, and that's all that matters for Robert C. Byrd, especially at this point.
14-point lead for the Big Reds, 28-14, Seth Bostaff. Over to Strakula. Dunaway looking outside to Strakula, going to try to drive the baseline. He's driven out of bounds. And we're going to have a foul called. No, they're just saying he went out.
I thought it was a foul as well, but
Yeah, we knew he went out there, but the way the whistle was blown looked like it might have been a foul. Matt Godfrey gets it to Jeremy Adams. Patsy loses the ball, kicks it back out. Shot taken, goes in for Jordan Morrison. That's a three.
Suddenly it's 11-point game.
Right. And coach just wants a 30-second timeout to be able to talk over things a little bit. 5 minutes, 5 seconds left to go. You're at 26-9 with the quarter, and now Parkersburg's high only puts 2 points on the board versus eight for Robert C. Byrd, and they're now within 11.
And which that's doesn't sound like a lot, but no, the way it was going.
Well, the momentum just is in their favor now.
And you wouldn't be able to tell he's ready to retire if you look down in the huddle and watch him. He's pretty fired up. And for the Big Reds, maybe just fell asleep a little bit. They had that big lead there at the end of the first quarter. And
when you kind of have a big lead like that, sometimes you kind of let off your game a little bit. And I think that's what Coach Brewer said. Guys, we've got to get back into it again.
Kicking the butt to get back into it, and that's exactly what Coach Brewer gave him.
Dunaway looks to his right. Bo Staff, Dunaway, over to Spracula for three, drains it.
That'll work out of a timeout.
And that gets you back in the game in a hurry. Dunaway takes the shot, or Dunaway tries to block the shot. Godfrey over to Patsy. Derek Patsy trying to find some way to get in there. Elbows,
yeah,
and he's
going
to be called with the travel.
That was a hop, skip, jump, a step, and then another hop, I think.
Follow the yellow brick road.
A few too many hops.
Dunaway.
This isn't the NBA. You're not allowed 10 steps.
That's right. Chris Dracula being guarded pretty handily there. Dunaway for three. That one goes.
And suddenly, Robert C. Byrd are thinking, wait a second, we just got within 11, couple threes, and you're back down pretty good. Then a turnover.
Matt Godfrey tried to take that shot, and he was very well guarded. Connor Loudon, check that. It's Shawn Michael. No, it is. I saw the three, and I was trying to catch what the first number was with.
It's a big
it
run.
Ends up being with Strakula. So that foul will go against Derek Patsy. That's his first team foul, number six. So the Big Reds will be on the 1+1. Strakula for three.
He got fouled.
He got fouled. That's going to be three shot opportunity.
That's a big no-no. In layman's terms, you do not want to foul a three-point shooter, and that's exactly what happened. And especially the Big Reds, because they just, like I said, rarely miss from the free throw line.
Now about 20 seconds later, Derek Patsy has drawn his second foul. First one's up and in for Chris Dracula.
And within a matter of about 1 minute, we went from an 11-point game to what could be, if he makes all three of these, a 20-point game.
What a difference 60 seconds makes. Michael Moore returns to the game for Derek Patsy, who is leaving, as I said, with two fouls in the past minute. And there it went. 20-point margin for the Eagles. Kyle Bowles returns for the Big Reds. Eagles, 3:44 left to go here in the second quarter of play. Down by 20.
And he double dribbled, they say. So just all sorts of problems, unforced errors, and just this whole first half, Randy, and I'm sure we'll talk more at halftime about it. Just no inside presence for Robert C. Byrd whatsoever.
Right.
I mean, they just cannot get the ball inside, and that hurts.
Jerome Dunaway to Seth Bostaff. Over to Connor Loudon. Back to Dunaway. Over to Kyle Bowles. Loudon. Dunaway. Takes the three himself. Off the back of the iron. Rebounded Loudon. Over to Kyle Bowles. To Dunaway. Out to Bowles for three. And it's a little long. Rebounded by the Big Reds. Great job there by Seth Bostaff as he was at the baseline. Was able to be able to capitalize on that one. And a
nice
good job there on a follow-up as it was Jordan Morrison taking the shot. Matt Godfrey with the assist and actually puts it in. Bostaff kicks it inside. Oh, my. Oh, my goodness. What a shove. And, yep, he didn't get by with that one. That's going to go against Matt Godfrey.
But what a pass by Donaway.
Yes, it was. Sean Michael.
That's the first time we've heard his
name.
With
the three-point play. He gets the basket plus the foul shot. Godfrey takes the shot.
Did he call that?
Out and in and out and in and finally finds the bottom. Back to a 20-point margin. Donaway all the way over to Bowles. Shot taken is up and in by Sean Michael, and he is on fire tonight.
Absolutely. Every time he touches it, it is gold. It's going
15
in.
15 points. Godfrey with the basket for Robert C. Byrd. And he has 7 second quarter points. Bostaff out to Dunaway. Over to Bowles. Back to Dunaway. Out to Bostaff. Over to Sean Michael. Takes the shot up, and he'll be fouled.
He almost flipped that one in as he was falling out of bounds, but at least he'll get to shoot two at the free throw line. And we don't keep this stat, but I can just imagine what the points in the paint
right
is turning out to be so far in this first half. Every trip down the floor, it seems like the Big Reds go inside easily. And there's a missed free throw.
Sean Michael's free throw is no good. That was a 1+1, so he had to make the first one to get the second one. Jeremy Adams to Jordan Morrison. Matt Godfrey. And he tries to pass it to his teammate Michael Moore, but he zigged when he should have zagged, and they weren't thinking along the same lines. One was thinking left, one was thinking right, but they were facing each other, so the right was the different direction. Back into the game for the Big Reds is Chase Smith, as Jerome Dunaway will take a seat. Bostaff will inbound it to Smith, who comes across the timeline for the Big Reds. Over to Bostaff, to Loudon. Back to Bostaff. Over to Smith. Looking to try to get it underneath to Jared Decker. Smith to Loudon. Over to Bowles. Bostaff, turnaround, jump shot, up and in.
That was a nice move.
Yes, it was. Jerome Adams to Michael Moore. Shot taken there by Jordan Morrison. Rebounded by Jeremy Adams. Up a little long. Seth Bostaff coming up with a rebound. Under 30 seconds now left in the half. Kyle Bowles with the deuce. Big Reds effectively have doubled the score now on Robert C. Byrd, 48-24. 10 seconds in the half. Weekly over to Michael Moore. Back to Weekly, who will try for three way downtown. And that will go out to the Big Reds, as they say it was last touched by Jeremy Adams. 1.1 seconds left. Connor Loudon with a long shot.
Hit the ceiling.
Off the rafters. So that's it for the first half of play. And after the first half on senior night, here at the Memorial Fieldhouse in Parkersburg, the Parkersburg Big Reds 48, the Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles 24, we'll be back with halftime statistics and a few other things going on here at PHS in just a couple of minutes.
Heifer's BP Service Center, a 24-hour full-service BP convenience store and service bays. We're here to keep you on the move 24 hours a day for lockout, jump starts, flat repair, and any size towing job is no problem. Make one call at your hook. Have a fender bender, request Heifer's. Capable of any tow job and quick service to Vienna and Parkersburg. Heifer's BP Service Center, serving the Mid-Ohio Valley for 30 years.
Sports fans, get ready. CAS Cable now has high-definition ESPN and WTAP. Watch your favorite games and shows in crystal-clear high-definition. It's so real, it's like being there. Sign up now and get CAS Cable's regular cable channels 2 through 98, plus a HD receiver with interactive programming guide, pay-per-view, and high-definition ESPN and WTAP, all for less than $50 a month.
What is going on in here?
I love high-def.
Call CAS Cable today, 420-2470. Some restrictions may apply.
As always, a great job by the Red Wings drill team here at Parkersburg High School. Well, halftime scoring, Sean. Parkersburg High came out in the second quarter. First quarter, they outscored the Robert C. Byrd Eagles by 26-9. Second quarter, they outscored them 22-15 when it looked like that Robert C. Byrd was going to have a little bit of momentum there coming into the second quarter.
Yeah, it did, and Clyde Brewer really called an important timeout, and out of that timeout, the Big Reds, I believe, went on a pretty good run, hit a couple threes right out of the timeout. And they just needed a little bit of a wake-up, and they got a wake-up. And just good job by the Big Reds of recovering after a sloppy start to the second quarter.
Well, they're getting set to give away the Kia that was being offered by the car dealership here, Warner Pontiac, and also, I think, WTAP in with a sponsorship on that, as well as some others, as
now
they
is your
will.
Name in this bucket over here. Because if so, we'll listen closely.
Yeah. So they're getting ready to give away the red Kia that has been on the front campus here at Parkersburg High School. And the principal of Parkersburg High, Ralph Byrd, is getting set with the tickets. Actually, what's going on at the same time we're getting ready for the tickets is the senior introduction of the Red Wings.
If I moved like they move, I wouldn't get out of bed for 2 weeks.
Well, let's look at scoring real quickly for the Big Reds. The leading scorer on the night is Sean Michael. He had 12 points in the first quarter, 5 points in the second quarter to accumulate his 17 he has on the night. 9 points for Chris Stracula, 6 points for Connor Loudon. Then with 4 points are Seth Bostaff and Kyle Bowles. 3 points, Jared Decker, Jeremy Donaway. 2 points for Anthony Smith. For the Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles, leading point scorer on the evening is Jordan Morrison with 8 points. 7 points for Matt Godfrey. 3 points for Derek Patsy. And then two apiece for Jonathan Griffin, Eugene Weekly, and Drew Skasic.
Really, Randy, in the second half, Robert C. Byrd. Well, their first problem of the evening at the beginning of the game, I thought, Randy, was the fact that they did not get back on defense. Their transition defense really
right.
just struggling and some stupid turnovers there in the first quarter. But overall, they just can't get the ball inside, and that's been a true problem for them.
Well, they've taken the shots from the outside, and in the first quarter they weren't going, but they've been a little bit more fortunate in the second quarter. However, the second quarter just ended up being unbelievably in favor of Parkersburg High, outscoring them, as I said, 22-15. Well, Principal Byrd once again is introducing Roger Shepard from WTAP. And I believe that's Mr. Warner from Warner Kia.
Warner Pontiac Kia.
Right you up.
Now I'm going to have that song stuck in my head all evening. Especially if I win the car.
Roger Shepard reaches down deep for a ticket. Roger, of course, a graduate here at Parkersburg High. Mitchell someone. Didn't get the last
Wasn't us, that's all that matters.
That's right. I was going to tell you what year Roger graduated, but he probably won't want me to do that because he and I graduated the same year.
That's back when they rode dinosaurs to school. No, I'm going to get decked before the end of halftime if I don't shut up. No, it wasn't that long ago.
Well, once again, we'll say it's senior night here, and the seniors from Parkersburg High have really stepped it up tonight. As let's just recognize the seniors once again. Chase Smith, Connor Loudon, Kyle Bowles, Sean Michael, Jared Decker, and Chris Stracula, along with Anthony Smith. And their leadership this year, along with the other senior, I guess you might say, on the Big Red squad, and that being head coach Clyde Brewer, who's coaching his last home game here at the Memorial Fieldhouse tonight, have come up with 19 wins on the season
by
as
far
opposed
the best,
to two losses.
Best team they've had in quite a few years, and this is just a tremendous basketball team, with along with George Washington and Huntington, really the three elite teams in the state of West Virginia all season long.
And you'd probably get some people talking a little bit differently up in Morgantown right now. They're always powerhouses up in the Morgantown area. You don't hear that much about them because mostly Parkersburg High is playing the Kanawha Valley teams in the MSAC, and you just don't hear that much a lot of times about those teams up there. But give them credit. They'll be there when state tournament time comes.
Absolutely. And, you know, not this year so much, but Wheeling Park included a lot of times with those teams. And
right.
They've struggled a little bit this year.
Yes, they have.
And I believe even have a losing record, which is extremely unusual for them. But
yes.
but you can never count them out. And come tournament time, the way this basketball tournament is set up in West Virginia, whether you like it or not, the regular season does not matter at all.
Right.
And, you know,
it's just kind of warm up for the rest of the season.
And a lot of people trying to get that change over the years, and it still hasn't changed. And really quite a shame, because a lot of times you look at Parkersburg South and Parkersburg High School, and they're both two of the best teams in the state, if you look at them quite a few years.
Right.
And unfortunately, both of them cannot make it to the state tournament the way it's set up.
So. Right. It's one of those teams is eliminated right off the bat in the sectional. And they've changed it. They have changed things a little bit this year with the state tournament, and that being that the teams that do make it to the state tournament will be seeded. So that is a different change this year that will putting their toe in the water to kind of see if things are going to materialize that would help out the tournament to be able to not get number one and number two being playing in the first game.
Right, and that happened, I believe, it's been 5 or 6 years ago with Parkersburg South and Beckman. They played in the very first round. And
that was a packed house that day.
It really was, and that's unfortunate for that to happen. But still, I don't like the sectionals and the way all of that's set up, but it's that way probably almost all the way across the country when it comes to high school basketball. How are they going to seed them?
I'm not real sure. I would say there's probably going to be an upper and a lower bracket, and the upper bracket will probably
be the regular season.
Yeah, I would say you're probably going to have number one being the upper bracket and number two being the lower bracket. So you'll have 1, 3, 5, and 7, like 2, 4, 6, 8, or something like that to be in the finals. Let's get back into basketball action here, as that's what we're here for tonight. Is senior night. Big Reds are up 48-24. Robert C. Byrd has the ball to start the third quarter of play. They kick it back out to Michael Moore. Then over to Matt Godfrey. That's rebounded by Jordan Morrison. They're being able to get these boards now, Sean. That's going to be a shot taken by Matt Godfrey, and it's going to be foul number 3 called on Anthony Smith.
That's really been the only damage, Randy, they've done underneath. They have drawn some fouls and gotten to the free throw line at times, and that's exactly what happened there.
Both Robert C. Byrd and Parkersburg High have one player with 3 fouls each. That's Anthony Smith for PHS and Matt Godfrey for Robert C. Byrd. 2 fouls for Derek Patsy and Stephen Collins. 1 for Jonathan Griffin and Eugene Weekly on Robert C. Byrd. And Kyle Bowles and Connor Loudon have 1 apiece for the Big Reds. Matt Godfrey, once again, will take the shot off the front of the rim. Rebounded Anthony Smith. He gets it to Jerome Dunaway as they bring it across the timeline. Looks to his right to Strakula. Over to Sean Michael. Back to Jerome Dunaway. Loudon gets it to Anthony Smith. Can't quite find the handle. Smith underneath. And it's up and in.
He's all by himself. Nobody near him.
That's what you call wide open.
Yes, it is. I could have scored that, perhaps.
Shot taken from outside. Won't fall for Jeremy Adams. Strakula to Connor Loudon. He's up, and he'll draw the foul as well as put the basket in.
If there was a skunk rule in basketball, we're getting close to it. But
I think
not.
We are.
52-24 now, and transitional baskets. This is the way we started the game.
Right. Michael Moore called on the foul. Connor Loudon taking advantage of that 3-point opportunity. Matt Godfrey across the timeline for the Eagles.
He's a free throw shooting machine.
Just kind of threads the needle to Jeremy Adams and back to Godfrey. Shot taken there by Derek Patsy. Dunaway comes across the timeline for the Big Reds to Strakula. Sean Michael back to Dunaway. Shot for 3 goes. Boy, that looked easy, didn't it?
It did. He just looked like he was as relaxed as he could be as he shot it.
That's his second one tonight. And returning the favor is Derek Patsy for Robert C. Byrd. Dunaway being more or less triple teamed.
He broke the triple team pretty easily too, Randy.
Yes, he did.
He's very quick.
Derek Patsy's going to be called on the foul, and that is his 3rd.
That was not a very smart foul either. It was one of those cheap reaching in fouls, and not one that you needed, especially since it's his 3rd foul.
Connor Loudon inbounds it to Jerome Donaway. He gets it over to Strapula. Looking for someone. That's Sean Michael. Trying to get it down to Anthony Smith. Strapula for three off the back of the iron. Matt Godfrey across the timeline. He's going to try to take it all the way himself. Kind of just alley-oops the thing up. And a heads-up play there by Derek Patsy. As it looked like Anthony Smith was easily going to get that rebound, but from behind, somebody just kind of batted it away. Derek Patsy picked it up, turned around, put it in. Strapula to Donaway. Go ahead, John.
Right now, Robert C. Byrd doing a nice job with their interior defense.
And we're going to have foul called underneath. See who that's going to go against.
That's on Patrick, isn't it?
Patsy?
Patsy. Patrick. Patsy.
Derek Patsy.
Yeah, sorry. That's his fourth.
Well, they haven't put it up yet. Still trying to see exactly what happened underneath there.
He was bumping, I believe, underneath the basket with Anthony Smith, and they called a foul on Patsy, so that's his fourth foul. He'll go to the bench.
Shot taken by Chris Strapula won't go from the side. Jordan Morrison loses control of it for a minute. Donaway almost there to steal it. Jeremy Adams called with the extra step.
Just one of those instances he started moving before he put the ball on the floor and got a little bit ahead of himself.
I have trouble with that when I chew gum. Donaway will bring it across the timeline for the Big Reds. He gets it through to Yahweh. I have trouble with that, too. Strapula to Donaway. Over to Loudon.
That was our Spanish version of the broadcast.
Donaway tries to throw it to Decker. Heads up play there by Robert C. Byrd, but he just can't take advantage of it as Jeremy Adams got the ball.
Well, I think he was shocked that he got the ball.
I think he was. Strapula takes the shot. He'll be fouled by, I believe, Jordan Morrison. Let's see. That's who it's going to go against. That's his first. And at the free throw line, shooting two will be Chris Strapula. It's up and in. Big Reds haven't missed many foul shots tonight. Have they missed any at all?
They've missed a couple. I know that Sean Michael missed the front end of a one-and-one early on, and I'm not sure who the other one
is. Second one's in, as opposed to how many in. Godfrey spoons it underneath to Michael Moore. Shot taken there by Stephen Collins.
13 for 15.
Not too bad.
No, it's not.
I'd take it.
Yeah. Some teams don't shoot that well layup-wise, let alone free throws. So
Dunaway, turnaround jump shot by Sean Michael, goes up and in.
You know, he never misses. I swear to you, every time he touches the ball, it goes in.
19 points on the evening. Matt Godfrey over to Stephen Collins. Then to Matt Godfrey. Kicks it out to Michael Moore, top of the key. Moore. Pass to Stephen Collins, and
found
he kind of gets flattened. That's going to go against Jared Decker.
When you've run into Jared Decker, you know you've ran into somebody, too. I'd like to see him and Smith wrestle each other. That'd be fun. Get the mats out, let them go at it.
Like two freight trains coming at you.
I'd be afraid to even referee that.
Morrison to Collins. All the way out to Eugene Weekly. Then all the way back to Jordan Morrison. Tries the baseline. That didn't work.
Well, just every time, Randy, that they get the ball underneath, it's just rushed. They don't have a good shot.
Strapula takes the shot. Bounces around. Decides it's not going to go. 60-33, 3:15 left to go here in the third quarter of play. Morrison to Collins for two. Oh. Big Reds bring it back. Donaway over to Strakula. Loudon, a little light on the touch there. Rebounded by Griffin. Jordan Morrison takes the shot up. And that was a little light touch, too. Dunaway kicks it back to Loudon. He wasn't ready for that one. Gets it to Decker. Follow up by Chris Tricool on the baseline. Good. Kind of a blind shot.
And if you ask Decker, that was a pass.
That's right.
A pass.
He meant that.
That's right.
I think that was by Griffin.
Tell you what, Randy, you take away the first quarter, and since then it's been a lot more closely contested, but just a disastrous first quarter for Robert C. Byrd has them in this big hole.
Decker on the pass from Strakula puts it in. Now 64-37. Trying to get the ball to somebody. They get it to Griffin. He's up and in. And trying to see what they're calling here. Oh, okay, we have somebody that is got to tie their shoe. That's Drew Skasic is
Velcro.
Want to make sure you tie that shoe so you don't have a flap. Coach offering his advice on how to tie the shoe.
I don't know if he's talking about the shoe. I don't know how you can aggressively tie a shoe.
Kyle Bowles with it for the Big Reds. Donaway looks to his left to Seth Bostaff. Underneath the basket to Connor Loudon, up and in, and guess what? He's got an opportunity for a three-point play.
He's had quite a few three-point plays.
Yes,
tonight.
He has. Stephen Collins is who's going to be fouled or called on the foul. That's his third. We've got Matt Godfrey with three and Derek Patsy with four. So Robert C. Byrd starting to come into some foul problems here in the third quarter.
Yeah, they are, and a lot of that comes for the Big Reds working underneath, and once they get it underneath, Robert C. Byrd just doesn't have the height or the size to block it, and when they're trying to block, they're fouling instead. And
Connor Loudon commits the foul this time. That's his second.
You know, it's 67-39, and Coach Brewer is still up on his feet.
Yes, sir. And you'll see that to the end of the game.
Retirement what?
They inbounded to Drew Skasic, who apparently has got his shoe tied real good now. Stephen Collins over to Eugene Weekly. Back out to Matt Godfrey, who sends it to Eugene Weekly for the shot. And we're going to have a foul called underneath. See the way that goes. That's going to go against Jonathan Griffin, his second. Team foul number six. So the next time, Big Reds will be on the 1+1.
That's the last thing Robert C. Byrd needs at this point.
Donaway just kind of goes up through the middle, off the back of the rim. Connor Loudon with the rebound to Seth Bostaff. To Michael. He can't find the bottom this time. Michael Moore brings it back across court for the Eagles. Drew Skasic. Skasic kind of lost the handle for a moment. Griffin back to Skasic.
They just look confused on the offensive
end. And they just kind of gave it to Kyle Bowles. He hands it to Donaway, and it goes. Wanted to give a little bit of suspense to the game.
That's right. It needs some of it, as it's a 30-point game right now.
Stephen Collins won't be able to capitalize on that one. Seth Bostaff coming up with a rebound, and the race is on. Oh, gets the pass to Shawn Michael, and it wasn't quite a good angle enough to be able to get it up here, but
why
he
not?
Tried to do everything he could to be able to control and get it in, but it just wouldn't go.
When you're up 30, you might as well try something
That's
like
right.
that.
Robert C. Byrd will inbound as Jonathan Griffin gets it in.
Chase Smith is like a little ball of energy. He just comes in.
He's on him.
And he's ready to go.
He's on Michael Moore. Just won't give in. Drew Skasic. Back to Jonathan Griffin. Can't find the handle. Loses it to Kyle Bowles. 1.5. Shots up. And it's off the mark.
Just
That's all
bit.
Right. 30-point lead now for the Big Reds. 69 for the Big Reds on senior night 2005, 39 for the Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles. We'll be back with the epilogue in 60 seconds.
Hi, I'm Katie Molinari, and for the past 2 years, I've been in Morgantown playing soccer for WVU. But before I was a Mountaineer, I suited up and played for the Patriots, right here. A lot has been accomplished at the Erickson Off-Course facility, and the construction of the grandstand will be the final step towards the completion of this awesome goal. Hundreds of you deserve our thanks and gratitude for turning this dream into a reality.
Thank you, West County.
Erickson All-Sports Facility, sponsored by Cosenza and Merriman, attorneys at law, when only the best will do.
Go South!
The Postal Annex in South Parkersburg is your shipping and copying center. The guys at the Postal Annex make it easy to ship your packages. They carry packing supplies, boxes, and they can even package up what you are sending for you. You can be sure your package will make it safely. The Postal Annex ships FedEx.
Getting ready to go to fourth quarter action here from the Memorial Fieldhouse. Drew Skasic will inbound it for the Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles. Ball's going to be almost stolen by Connor Loudon. Controlled ultimately by the Eagles.
Well, it's like the Big Reds just decided all of a sudden, let's play really good defense.
Yes, they did. They forced a turnover for the Eagles. Seth Bostaff will inbound it for the Big Reds. He gets it to Chase Smith.
I want to see him score just to see the reaction from the student section.
Here's an opportunity. Off the back of the iron.
Just won't go in for him.
Morrison to Griffin. Check that, Collins. Shot taken a little light on the touch there by Chris Davison.
Nice job of keeping the ball alive by Robert C. Byrd, but then they just threw it away.
30-point margin.
Come on, Chase, dunk it. Oh, I don't think he can do that.
Chase Smith brings it across the timeline. Looks left, then right. Seth Bostaff to Connor Loudon, and it'll stay with the Big Reds as it was off the hand of Stephen Collins. Substitutions in for the Eagles as Derek Patsy and Jordan Morrison report in, as well as Matt Godfrey. Seth Bostaff will inbound it for the Big Reds. It's to Connor Loudon, over to Chase Smith. Smith looks to his right to Kyle Bowles. Cross-court pass to Smith. Can't find a handle. Finally gets it. Bowles. Jump shot up. And in. Boy, that was pretty.
Yes, it was. Looked relaxed as can be. Looked like me a little bit, Randy.
Shots up and in for Matt Godfrey.
Anybody that knows me knows that's a joke. But
yeah. Only way that would be me is if I was playing a video game at the time. Bostaff to Kyle Bowles. Ball stolen away.
Good
and
hustle.
Then possession lost by Matt Godfrey, so the Big Reds will...
No.
Nope. Check that. It's going to go in for the Eagles. Chris Trakula will report back in as Chase Smith comes out. Byrd having some trouble inbounding it here. They get it into Matt Godfrey. Ball stolen away, and it's going to be sent forward to Seth Bostaff. He sends it behind him to Kyle Bowles. But you know what? There was another guy behind him by the name of Chris Davison picked that one up. Davison gets a rebound. My goodness, who's got the ball here?
The ball's flying everywhere. And finally, it ends up with a charge against Robert C. Byrd.
Derek Patsy, that is number 5 on him. He's coming out. So the coach has 60 seconds to make that substitution. Have they replaced him yet?
I hope, because we started playing.
I was trying to see who came in.
They certainly don't need to be down 5-4.
Michael Squires came in. That's who it was. Strakula over to Loudon for three. Anthony Smith coming up with a rebound. It's batted away. It'll stay with the Big Reds, though. As Connor Loudon turns over to Coach Brewer, he said, did you see that?
Well, they kind of got clotheslined.
Anthony Smith up and in.
That was pretty.
Matt Godfrey.
To Robert C. Byrd, how do you stay motivated to play the last 5 minutes?
You let your JVs play. Those guys are hungry.
So am I, but not to play basketball.
Kyle Bowles hands it back to Connor Loudon for the deuce. Now 75-41.
Godfrey. Somebody has a scream. Did you hear that?
I heard that. Godfrey, as he's falling, gets the pass to Jordan Morrison, who takes the shot. Big Reds rebound. Strakula, Bowles for three. And we're going to have a foul called underneath the basket. It's probably a pushing foul.
It's going to be on Robert C. Byrd.
It's going to go against Jonathan Griffin. That's his third. At the free throw line will be Connor Loudon shooting two. Check that, 1+1. He'll have the opportunity to shoot two, but he's got to sink the first one to get the second one.
More than likely he will.
His record tonight?
Oh, geez.
Oh, my. I jinxed him, didn't I?
I did, too. That was our fault.
Sorry, Connor. My bad. Jeremy Adams.
Obviously, Byrd having a hard time keeping their footing.
Over to Morrison. Shot up.
That was blocked by
Kyle Bowles is going to be called with that
actually,
one.
Actually, it's going to be a foul call.
That is his second. Big Red still not on the one-and-one defensively yet. That's going to be a two-shot foul, though, as Jordan Morrison was in the act of shooting whenever he was fouled, so he'll be shooting two. First one's away, off the back of the rim.
So with 4:48, it's pretty safe to say, 4:48 left in the game, it's pretty safe to say that the Big Reds are going to send Brewer out the way he should be sent out with a victory here tonight.
But not just a victory, a resounding victory.
Yes, unless there's a 30-point shot that you could hit in basketball, this one's over.
Seth Bostaff gets the pass to Chris Trapula, back to Bostaff. Looking underneath to Connor Loudon, takes the shot. He's double-teamed, and the ball is deflected out, but it was off an eagle, so the Big Reds will inbound it. Seth Bostaff will bring it in. Looks all the way out to Strakula. Underneath, the Bostaff takes the shot, rebounded Anthony Smith.
And he got hit in the head, I think, that time. But
Kyle Bowles out to Chris Strakula. Back to Bowles. Tries to drive the baseline. Shot up. A little hard on the touch. Byrd coming up with a rebound. Pass underneath to Michael Moore. Big Reds pick it up as Kyle Bowles sends it forward to Chris Strakula. And it's up and in. Jeremy Adams out to Jordan Morrison. That one kind of rolls around a little bit before Morrison sinks that one.
We're probably going to have, I think, some substitutions before the end of the game. Probably the JV team in for the Big Reds. Because I don't know, it's senior night. They might kind of leave the seniors in.
Chris Strakula sinks that one for the Big Reds. Now it's 80-44. Morrison up and in for the Flying Eagles. Kyle Bowles to Connor Loudon. Bowles kind of puts the brakes on, kicks it back to Loudon for three, and that's good.
The threes are raining down.
Yes, right they here. Are. Oh, my.
I think he walked a little bit there with it.
Michael
shuffle.
Squires gets the benefit of the benefit. But, hey, what the heck. Being bent down behind this far, I can see that. Kyle Bowles. up and just simply led the Big Reds to that win in that final game. So
absolutely. So Parkersburg South, that's some fuel to use for
right,
them,
and
most of those guys weren't on that
team,
of course.
Yeah, and that's the thing that we've got to look at this year. The Big Reds very highly rated, and Parkersburg South coming in as kind of maybe the spoiler in that particular instance to see whether they can win that sectional or Parkersburg High can win it. Now, I will say, if Parkersburg High is able to get by South in that sectional game, I don't think there's too many teams in the state, if they're on their game, I think the PHS has a very good chance of going all the way.
Right. And there's no doubt in terms of talent level, no disrespect to Parkersburg South, in terms of talent level, the Big Reds are probably beyond what Parkersburg South is, but it's one of these rivalry games, and it seems like, I mean, both of these games this season have been just extremely close down to the last couple minutes between the Big Reds and the Patriots, so it should be fun next week.
Right. Okay, our final score for the final time here on Senior Night 2005, Parkersburg High School Big Reds 88, the Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles 57. On behalf of my broadcast partner, Sean Murray, as well as the folks at CAS Cable who have brought you the games this year, we'd like to have you to frequent the sponsors of the broadcast and tell them thank you for bringing high school basketball into your family room. This is Randy Kinsolving. Until next time, have a good evening, everyone.
The guys at the Postal Annex make it easy to ship your packages. They carry packing supplies, boxes, and they can even package up what you are sending for you. You can be sure your package will make it safely. The Postal Annex ships FedEx, UPS, and U.S. Mail. But there's more to the Postal Annex than just shipping and copying. They have a great selection of handmade crafts, too. Stop by the family-run Postal Annex in South Parkersburg today.
Heifer's BP Service Center, a 24-hour full-service BP convenience store and service base. We're here to keep you on the move 24 hours a day for lockout, jump starts, flat repair, and any size towing job is no problem. Make one call at your hook. Have a fender bender, request Heifer's, capable of any tow job and quick service to Vienna and Parkersburg. Heifer's BP Service Center, serving the Mid-Ohio Valley for 30 years.
Sports fans, get ready. CAS Cable now has high-definition ESPN and WTAP. Watch your favorite games and shows in crystal-clear high-definition. It's so real, it's like being there. Sign up now and get CAS Cable's regular cable channels 2 through 98, plus a HD receiver with interactive programming guide, pay-per-view, and high-definition ESPN and WTAP, all for less than $50 a month.
What is going on in here?
I love high def.
Call CAS Cable today, 420-2470. Some restrictions may apply.
The good thing about this place is it's not done yet. And the good thing about stuff that isn't done is there's still something to work for. And we still have something to work for here. And what's important right now is that we need to get together and we need to try to finish this facility. There's still a lot that needs to be done here, and we need all you people to support it and do what's important now. We need to win in finishing this facility.
Erickson All Sports Facility, sponsored by Cosenza and Merriman, attorneys at law. When only the best will do.
Go South!
Everybody loves the Piper.
The cheese sticks are smothered in cheese, just the way I like them.
The baked subs are incredible, and there's so many to choose from.
If you like wings, the Piper's has you covered.
The Piper's calzones are the best.
I love the baked spaghetti.
The salads are fantastic.
Piper's Pizza.
And remember, delivery is now available. Piper's Pizza, with two great locations, 8th and Division Street in South Parkersburg and 3209 Grand Central Avenue in Vienna.
Help finish the Erickson All Sports Facility and show your support for South. Get your Mad Max bobblehead doll today. No South fan should be without a Mad Max bobblehead. There's wrestling Mad Max, basketball Mad Max, and of course everybody's favorite, football Mad Max. Mad Max bobbleheads are only $15, and what's better than one Mad Max bobblehead? All three for only $40. Erickson All Sports Facility, sponsored by Cosenza and Merriman, attorneys at law. When only the best will do.
Today's computer has hundreds of megs of RAM, 3D video acceleration, and does over 1.4 billion operations a second. and you're still using a 56K dial-up modem? Your computer was made for a high-speed cable modem. Pages popping, music playing, and shopping? Oh, baby. And you know that sound your computer makes when it's connecting?